Wanted to discuss a little bit about the fact that Orthodox rabbis today are judicial positivists. What does that mean? So, just to sort of explain what I mean, as give it an example, I guess. Let me sort of try to show what's on the opposite side of that. The opposite side of judicial positivism is natural law. And, you know, that's obviously stated in the Rambam, the Mor Nevuchim, and, you know, and all of the Rishonim that came after him, the Sefer Chinuch, later on in the Kabbalah. We always have that idea that the mitzvot, there's a sublayer, a substructure of principles underneath the mitzvot, which give to the mitzvot the moral force. The mitzvot themselves don't have the moral force, whether they're in the Talmud, whether even in Torah law. That's Darshan Taima Dekra, which the Rambam understands in a sort of wide way, even putting that that principle to Rebbe Yehuda in Bava Metzia, who is, by all intents and purposes, isn't Darshan Taima Dekra over there in Bava Metzia, and yet the Rambam, right there in the Pirshei Mishnayos, says that he is. So it seems to be a pretty clear principle within Torah. But most rabbis, maybe many are not conscious of it. I'm really not sure where it comes from, but it certainly hit me right in the face when I saw this, how different it was than Talmud, the attitude of Orthodox rabbis, and that they supposedly take their cue from the Talmud, but, you know, they don't think they can be rationally questioned, because what they say, that gives the moral force to whatever they say. The yeshivas and Orthodox rabbis give total and complete totalitarian force to what are actually just mere social and cultural traditions, have nothing to do with the Talmud at all, and can't be rationally questioned. That's even more totalitarian than Hegel, that even believed that, you know, had his sort of his approach to absolutism, that there's one unvarying truth, but that it was but that the underlying principle behind it was reason, so it could always be rationally discussed. You can't do that with rabbis, because they're judicial positivists along the lines of Wurti, that it's overly hostile to any type of idea that somebody could disobey their word, even if their word is grossly unjust and completely opposed to what it says in the Talmud. And it might be wise for people to be aware of that when their loyalty, you know, comes into the Torah. You know, you want to know what the Torah says, what the Talmud says, and yet it might be well warned that rabbis really don't care what the Talmud says at all. They consider their own word to be of judicial totalitarian force, and even when it's completely contradicted in the Talmud. Okay, well, thank you for listening.